So let me explain the absolute convergence test by giving you some examples. In the future, I will give you the actual theorem. But roughly speaking, if you're trying to determine whether or not this alternating series will converge or if it will diverge, what you do is you look at the absolute value of this. So have a look at the absolute value. And then if this whole thing here, so the theorem, roughly speaking, the theorem says that if this whole thing here converge, then what you're trying to investigate will also converge. But if this thing here diverge, then it tells us nothing about the original. The original could diverge or it could converge. If this thing here diverge, then it tells us nothing about this thing here. The reason why we're taking the absolutes here is because this becomes a lot easier to investigate. For example, let's say we're trying to determine if this alternating series will converge or if it will diverge. So what we do is we look at the absolute value here. So looking at this, remember all this thing is doing, all this thing is doing here is doing plus minus. That's all that this thing is doing as n increases from 1 to infinity. But then when you look at the absolute value of it, so remember this thing here, all it's doing is doing negative 1 plus 1. That's all that it's doing. But when you take the absolute value here, you no longer care about the minus. So this thing here, so you can imagine this as being between, you can imagine this as being between 0 and 1, between 0 and 1. Because when you take the absolute value, you don't care about the negative. You don't care about the negatives. So by right, this thing here is between -1 and 1. But when you take the absolute value here, you can think of it in your mind as being between 0 and 1. Because you're taking the absolute value here. So rather than looking at this complicated thing here, we know for sure that this thing here would be less than or equal to 1 because of this. So we can compare this. We can compare this to this. So this whole thing here will always be bigger or equal to this thing here. Just because when you take the absolute value of this thing here, it has to be in between here and here. So it has to be less than 1. It has to be less than 1 here. So this thing here has to be less than 1. So we can say that this whole thing here must be greater or equal to this whole thing here. But then by looking at this, you should immediately be able to tell that this thing here will converge. So by now, it will, hang on, bear with me. This should be 1. Sorry, hang on. This should be 1. And this here should be 1 infinity. So by now, you should be able to just tell that this thing here will converge because of this P here. If this thing here is greater than 1, then you know this thing here will converge. You see, number 2 is greater than 1. So this thing here will converge. Well, if this thing here converge and it's bigger than this thing here, then this thing here must also converge. Now, going back to here, remember, this thing here is exactly the same as this thing here. So we know this thing is going to converge. Therefore, this thing here must also converge. Okay? So let me give you another example. So let's have a look at this one here. So let's say we're trying to determine whether this alternating series will converge or if it will diverge. If you look at this sine of n, so sine looks like this. It's going to be 1 minus 1 and so on. Sine of n will be in between minus 1 and 1. So we are trying to determine whether this alternating series will converge or it will diverge. There's a theorem, which I haven't stated yet, that says that if you look at the absolute version of this, if the absolute version converge, then this will have no choice but to also to converge. That's what the theorem is saying. So now let's look at the absolute version of this. Let's look at the absolute version. Remember, sine of n is trapped in between -1 and 1. But when you take the absolute here, when you take the absolute here, you ignore the negative. So in your mind, you can actually think of it like this, being because you've taken the absolute here. But well, the point here is that sine of n will always be less than or equal to 1. So this thing here will always be less than or equal to 1 here. So we can actually make this statement. This thing here will always be bigger or equal to this thing here. So now by now you should be able to recognize that because this is bigger than 1, this thing here will converge. Well, if this thing here is bigger or equal to this thing here, if this converges, then this will also converge. So when you take the absolute here, this thing here will converge. Now going back to here, now we know that this will converge. So therefore, there's a theorem that says that if you take the absolute value here, and then this thing here converges, then the original thing that you're trying to investigate will also converge. Okay, so this alternating series will actually converge. Okay.